general, you can't say nothing about apostasy laws. Treason, where's Edward Snowden?
Those are wrong.
Where is Edward Snowden?
I'm against that. He should be free.
My friend, you live in a bubble. It's a dream world. Islam is not bothered with you just coming. I'm an ex-Muslim. Oh, attack you.
That's a hadith.
It doesn't look.
The hadith says that I should be killed.
No, you don't know. You're just quoting a hadith. You don't know the context. You don't know why it was reviewed.
I understand that you think it's against Islam,
yes,
but you do acknowledge that a lot of ex-Muslims do get threatened.
No, not a lot. Sorry. Some do.
A lot. People.
No, some. Sorry.
Maybe not in the UK.
Look, let me tell you something.
How do you know that it's not a lot?
Let me tell you why, yeah? I don't find a need. I don't think there is anyone that would say Islam says kill the apostate.
You don't need.
That's the reason why I'm doing it. That's nonsense. You know why? Let me tell you why. Because number one, we live in this country.
Great.
You can't apply the Sharia in that angle. It's not Islamic.
Okay, you changed two things here, right? The two things that you changed, first of all, you said I wasn't talking about you.
No, I'm talking about Islam.
Okay. You changed three things, right? Even if you agree that it's not in accordance with Islam, a lot of Muslims still do it, even if you think it's not occurring with Islam. We do get a lot of threats. That's not a lie. Even
you get threats for what? Because probably if you're insulting Islam.
No.
Let me tell you
the things that you changed. You said you don't do it. You don't care.
Just because I don't, doesn't mean others don't.
The third thing you said, in this country,
yes,
most of the death threats that ex-Muslims get, yes, is not in this country. We're talking about ex-Muslims that live in Saudi Arabia, in Bangladesh, in Pakistan, in Iran, in Indonesia, in Malaysia.
Yeah.
Those are the ex-Muslims that are getting the death threat. I have received death threat, but that's not nearly as much.
I received death threat.
I know, I'm just saying. No. You're not paying attention.
From
I'm
the
saying,
far right.
I wasn't saying, you're missing my point. I'm saying it wasn't a big deal. My death threat is not a big deal. I live in a free country, I'm protected. I'm talking about the death threats that ex-Muslims in Iran and Saudi Arabia and Bangladesh and Pakistan. Those ex-Muslims living there, they are living in fear.
Okay?
I understand that you're saying you don't think that's Islamic, but those...
No, I never said that.
Right.
In an Islamic country, there is laws and regulations.
Yeah. Right.
Okay?
Right.
So, you have heard of something called social contracts?
Right.
Have you heard of it? We have social contracts.
Yeah,
nobody came and asked you. Do you agree? This. You are born into it.
Yeah.
Immanuel Kant and...
I know.
Yes? So, I'm going to jump in detail, yeah?
Yeah.
So, the thing is, don't make this exclusive to Islam. Apostasy laws is there once again?
I didn't.
Once again, it's there. If an Islamic country has that in place, you don't need to live there. You can go.
They can't go.
No. You can go. We live in the 21st century.
No.
You can go.
Excuse me.
If I left Islam in Saudi Arabia, I would save my ticket and I would migrate to another country.
You know, then you don't know. It's impossible for most people to get a visa to leave Iran or Saudi Arabia or Pakistan.
Okay.
Right?
Most of them
are trying to.
No. I don't need to tell anybody I'm an ex-Muslim. If I say in my heart, I don't believe anymore, I don't want to leave here, I want to go. You can.
No, they can't. They can't get a visa. I come from Iran, man.
So nobody leaves Iran at all?
No, it's unless you come from a position of privilege where they can afford to take...
Can somebody go holiday to Turkey?
Most people that can, they're upper class.
No. Does anybody not save enough ticket to go to another country?
To countries where they can get a visa to... I don't know, does Turkey need a visa for Iranians?
No, I don't know, but you're making it seem like it's impossible. And I'm saying
it's
sometimes...
It's impossible to go and
no,
stay.
I know.
Okay, yeah.
Sometimes you make it something
they
can, it's not.
Okay.
I've seen a lot of ex-Muslims do this. They were trying to kill us.
Getting visa for Turkey is easy, okay? But it's hard to stay there. You have to come back. You have to come back. They cannot leave the country. They cannot go and just come and live in you in a free country in like UK. A lot of them try to run away like that. But the thing is that...
But Iran is also different. Like Islam, I don't even...
Pakistan.
Secular run.
Where is it?
No, but I'm saying even in Islamic country.
No.
I'm saying Islamically.
I'm not even judging Islam, okay? Right now I'm not saying that Islam is bad or good.
Okay.
I'm not doing that right now. I'm just what I'm doing right now is saying the threat is there. It is.
I accept right? the threat is there.
Right.
But sometimes.
But don't say that they're not getting death threats.
No. They make it out every time they attack. Oh, it's because of the Apostasy. They have this kind of mentality.
But ex-Muslims in Pakistan is because they're ex-Muslim and nothing else.
I'm sorry. Like I said to you before, I think sometimes it's being blown out of proportion and it's being used.
In Pakistan, yes. If you come out openly as an ex-Muslim, you are in danger. In Bangladesh, if you come out as an ex-Muslim, you have a target on your back.
Okay.
I will give you this. In Canada, if you come out as an ex-Muslim, you're safe. Okay? In United Kingdom, if you come out as an ex-Muslim, unless your family is extreme, you're safe, you know?
What if you come against the country? Why if you come against? So for example,
I'm right now I'm talking about the real threat is there. Don't say ex-Muslims are not receiving threats. I'm not receiving threats. Look at this. I'm safe.
Most ex-Muslims, they use this to make a big scene out of it. So if anybody threatens them, it's because I'm ex-Muslim. It's because of Apostasy law. Nonsense.
Okay.
Nonsense. That's why I said to him, show me you saying this, because Islamically, what is that person is doing this?
Let me tell you.
So you're blowing out of proportion.
I say Muslims are being targeted because they're Muslim.
Yes.
And that's a big deal. Okay?
Of course.
Christians are being targeted because they're Christians.
Yes.
And that's a big deal to me. I'm not blowing that out of proportion. When Muslims are being targeted in India because they're Muslim, I will point that out, and I'm not blowing that one out of proportion. That's a real problem. Okay? In the same way, when ex-Muslims are being targeted because they're ex-Muslims, I'm not going to exaggerate that. I'm going to say it like it is. That's a big deal. And I'll admit this, not enough ex-Muslims are supporting Muslims when they're being attacked.
I know that.
Okay? More ex-Muslims need to speak on behalf of Muslims.
No, they're too busy making money.
No, come on. I'm being fair here.
Yeah, I'm being fair here. No, that's what I'm saying.
But I'm just saying, just like more ex-Muslims need to defend Muslims, more Muslims should also defend ex-Muslims and acknowledge
them. Defend them on what?
Acknowledge the threat that exists to the life of ex-Muslims.
By who?
By Muslims.
No, by which Muslims? The ones who are ignorant. They're doing it for the same.
Whatever, whoever it is, you should defend them even if they're. You think they're fake? Okay, how about this? They're fake Muslims. They're not good Muslims. They're not following Islam.
You're not understanding what I'm saying.
Whatever.
You're not understanding what I'm saying.
Please explain to me what I'm.
I believe this notion is used of ex-Muslims. Whenever they leave, they want some kind of recognition. If they get attacked. If they leave Islam, somebody punches them, it's because I'm ex-Muslim. They fall down the road, it's because I'm ex-Muslim. Nonsense. However, there are people who also attack certain ex-Muslims.
Right.
I don't deny that. But the ex-Muslim community...
What?
No, man.
Okay, let me see.
I'm fighting over petrol prices.
I agree with you. Okay, let me see. I agree. Okay,
so let me. I'm against those who use it to capitalize.
Okay.
But those, and what they do is it's an insult to the ones who are genuinely going through it.
Okay, so you acknowledge that they're genuinely ex-Muslims.
Of course, I never said.
Can you say something to protect them? Right?
One second.
Can you highlight the genuine ones?
No, one second. If they are causing problems in an Islamic country, by that law of that land, I have nothing to say about nothing. Why? Because, one second. If it's an Islamic country, or let's suppose it's an American country, you cannot speak, like in France, you can't speak against the flag. One second, you cannot speak against the flag.
That's a bad law.
One second, that's their law.
That's a bad law.
No, one second, if you don't like it, leave the country.
No, fight it.
My friend, that is their law.
Why should you follow the bad law?
My friend, you defined it with your subjective understanding.
Do you, Do you think Rosa Park was? Do you think when Rosa Park refused to sit at the back of the bus, would you? Do you think that was a good decision or a bad decision? When she decided to break the law, Rosa Park.
No, no, no. You're conflating two things. You're talking about a real injustice too. If a law is there, for example, about
that's an injustice. Injustice.
Listen. I want to make this something very simple and clear. Yeah? I'm saying this here. Yeah? Most ex-Muslims, the ones that are genuine, the ones that are fake, they come with a lot of fake stuff. They come up and they use it, they abuse it, yeah? Oh, I'm
everybody,
because okay. Understand. What they do is that, however, there are genuine people who do get attacked, yeah? That they shouldn't, by Muslims who are not using Islam, they're okay. Using their emotions, they don't just don't like them.
Okay.
So I think this is of your friend.
When Muslims are actually genuinely being attacked,
yes.
Some Muslims use that, abuse, yes. Right? Yes. When Christians are being genuinely attacked, when Christians are targeted for their Christianity, some other Christians abuse them.
Yes.
That shouldn't distract us from the genuine Christians that are being attacked, or the genuine Muslims that are being attacked. So what I'm asking, that even if there are some ex-Muslims that are maybe like taking advantage of...
Maybe focus on the actual point you're saying.
Yeah, what I'm saying is that ex-Muslims that are abusing the fact that are not genuine, those shouldn't be your main focus. The main focus should be the ex-Muslims that are genuinely being targeted for being ex-Muslims.
Okay.
Just like with Muslims.
No, if that's the case, we need to look. Where? Which country? Is that an Islamic country? Or they claim to be an Islamic country? But kids are doing it. What's it? There was an instance...
Why does it matter as long as they're being targeted?
You're missing the point. Let's say
it's an Islamic country that claims to be an Islamic country, but it's not an Islamic country.
No. If it's an Islamic, proper Islamic country, then there is laws on apostasy and treason. Those laws are there.
And those are justified?
No. That laws, yes. They are justified. They're 100% justified, yeah?
That's bad.
No. They're justified, yeah? For a reason. There are stipulations. It's not just the way you think about it, yeah? It's justified. You conflating that with a group of childish little kids want to attack someone. Why?
You think apostasy laws are justified?
No, of course. In this country, what are you talking about? Immanuel Kant talks about this.
I'm not talking about this country.
No. 1 second. In general, you can't say nothing about apostasy laws. Treason. Where's Edward Snowden?
Those are wrong.
Where is Edward Snowden?
I'm against that. He should be free.
My friend, you live in a bubble. It's a dream world.
I'm against treason laws.
If there is things that put the state in jeopardy, capital punishment.
Coming out and saying I'm an ex-Muslim putting a state in jeopardy.
No. You're missing the point. The Sharia came to defend the religion of the people. Yeah. So you come in and putting a false narrative forward to you. It's nothing. I'm just saying I'm ex-Muslim. But to the state, Islam is there to protect the community as a whole.
Oh,
you, your words. See, this is what I'm saying. Your words. If somebody comes and says, "Let's have a revolution."
Is Islam that weak that me coming out and saying?
I'm saying anyways.
No, okay, I'm sorry. But I'm just saying that I don't think it's the same thing. I don't think me coming out and saying I'm an ex-Muslim.
No. Look. Islam is not bothered with you just coming. I'm an ex-Muslim. Attack him.
That's a hadith.
It doesn't look.
The hadith says I should be killed.
No, you don't know. You're just quoting a hadith. You don't know the context. You don't know why it was revealed. You don't know what it's for. Some even say because the Jews used to accept Islam and leave.
No. The hadith. I read the hadith in full before and after it as well, and the commentary on it.
Baba, there is one that said one who leaves Islam and abandons his community. Yeah. So there's different hadith. Don't.
No. This one is hadith Bukhari.
No.
And it's multiple.
One hadith doesn't work like this. You have.
This is multiple hadiths.
My friend. There are hadiths that say something. The Prophet said, do not pee standing. And also, there was times where he would urinate standing. How do we understand them both?
You look at the chain of narration.
Not
the
only that, no. How do you bring them together in harmony? So, a verse in the Quran says, kill the infidels wherever you find them. Chapter 60 verse 8 said, Allah does not forbid you from being just and kind to them. Hold on a second. Should I be kind to them or should I kill them?
Abrogation.
No, this is not abrogated. So how do we understand them? It's talking about the ones who do not attack you based on your faith. That's about the enemies of Islam.
That would be a different discussion. We could have that.
That's what I'm saying. So don't quote hadith out of context.
No, this one, hadith itself is hard to take out of context because every single part of it... Okay, never mind. But
no,
that's a different...
Context.
This is a different discussion. But you said 8:30 we go eat. Can we go now?
Yeah, we're going to go. Let me pack you up.
Can I help with you packing up?
Yeah, I don't know.
Atheists are under attack in many places. If they were Christians, their voices would be heard. If they were Jews, their voices would be heard. If they were Muslims, their voices would be heard. But they are atheists, and not many seem to be listening. let's make it difficult for them to ignore us. We have built a global community, and now we are tearing down geographic, cultural, and language barriers so we can find each other and support each other. In the last decade, we have built the largest atheist community in the world. Now we're doing the same in other languages. With your help, we have started Atheist Republic in Persian and Arabic.
انضميت مؤخرا لأسرة Atheist Republic وحيصير عندي بودكاست باللغة العربية.
As we grow, we can dedicate more time, staff, and resources to start doing the same in Spanish, Portuguese, Malay, Bengali, Urdu, Hindi, and other languages. We are providing community, support, informative content, and amplifying the voices of those who need protection, especially in countries where people feel isolated simply for their lack of belief. We want to be there for them, and we are only getting started. Help us get there. Check in the description for ways you can support our projects.